So this is the bike that I got from the RAVI loan, and I use it in delivering flour, carrying passengers from one place to another. And I love it because I'm sure that I'm going to repay back the loan as soon as possible, as I continue, because it is still making my delivery simple and efficiency. So let me see if we can get another order so that I can deliver it as to the customer as soon as possible.
RAVI loans are there to build the capacity of the rural entrepreneurs. Once an entrepreneur has gone through our loan learning scheme, they are now much more able to go to the bank with a proposal that is viable.
Elijah Kinanjui Kigori is one of those entrepreneurs. He works for a Kenyan marketing company called AgriTrade, and he's based in the town of Nakuru, the provincial capital of Kenya's Rift Valley.
I've got different business that I undertake here in our town, transporting goods from the farmer and also to the wholesale market, and also from the wholesale market with the estate grocery. Also, I also coordinate with the other milling companies to transport their produce. And when doing all this, I get a commission. If I can afford maybe to sell around 10 bags, at least I have got around 500 bob per day. I couldn't afford to do all this apart from the support from the RAVI. It's very impossible for you to get a loan from other institutions. The response of RAVI loan was not like any other institution, because other institutions will give you a lot of conditions, whereby as a common man like me, getting maybe a title deed, a correct loan, a log book, it cannot work. But for RAVI, I can say it is a mutual understanding that they want to help people to uplift their businesses and to uplift their standard and to continue their network. So this is the motorbike.
I chose that because it's very strong. This was the agri-loan agreement. I have to put all my expenses down, whatever I do as far as the motorbike is concerned, so that I can see if I'm going to loss or I'm going at a profit. But I'm making some success here and there. Some of the receipts, I have to put them there for future reference.
RAVI loans aren't easy, they are difficult. It's not hard because we require collateral, and it's not hard because we require trading records, because we don't. What's hard is that we require a good business idea with a significant amount of due diligence around the figures and around the expectations, particularly of income streams. The hardship about getting a RAVI loan is around dealing with all the questions we throw at them to make sure that their business idea is sound.
I was asked many questions, and I was answering them. They asked me about what was the purpose of the loan, how are you going to pay this loan? If you are not, if the loan is not going to be paid, what other income stream do you have? Then I usually ask and ask myself, all these questions are good for me, because this loan I have to pay back, and I have to be very, very transparent in what I'm doing. So that is Neema shop. And he has been very supportive. Oh, this is an order that was made through the phone, as most of my customers have my number. So after they called, it was raining, so I had to wait for the rain to stop, and now I'm here. And Neema shop, Neema General Shop is one of my customers ever since July until to date. The commission of one bag like this one is only 50 shillings, just like town service, just like carrying somebody to town, get 50 shillings. So you use maybe around 20 shillings for the fuel, then you are left with 30 shillings. So you have to carry as many times as possible so that you can make at least something at the end of the day. As we have finished putting in the customer's house, it was like now you can see this is an estate whereby they use the front house for business and the back house for their living. So as if prepare for the cash to take to the miller, and then I get my commission. From there, I look for another tender to deal with, or I can carry maybe a person, or can take another bag to another customer. I have to wipe it a bit so that if I'm going to carry a customer, he can see that my motorbike is clean and it is not for flour carrying, but it is for multi-purpose, carrying flour. And the repayment is supposed to be around 13,000 and 800 and something and 25, which I can see maybe after 15, maybe I cleared the first repayment. Oh, this is my commission. As I have to put it aside so that it does not mix with the owner's money. This is my commission, which is if I get maybe 10 customers, it can be okay because you can earn 500. Then from there, this is for the miller. I calculate is 3,000 for one bag of 90 kg. So I can say thanks to my customer because they have been supportive when I was having a bicycle, and now I have got the motorbike. They have been supportive to me, particularly the Neema General Shop in Manyani. This Manyani is neighboring Lake Nakuru National Park, whereby you can see maybe some animals after we finish the everything. I'm okay.
To date, we have no defaulters, but we do have rescheduling when people run into a drought, when people run into some unfair trading. While in RAVI we require no collateral and we require no trading record, we do rely on we're sharing that learning experience with all the other loan learners on the internet. And that acts as a very strong motivation for them to stick to the loan. And when you add on top of that the fact that they know that when they've repaid their loan, somebody else in the network can get access to a loan to grow their business, that is also another motivation for those who take loans to repay their loans promptly.
I don't know, maybe other banks, if they can change, they can do well. Like for me, RAVI has done a very great thing unto me and also unto my family and also unto my business. I can say that live longer, RAVI.